I am super excited to bring you this video because I always enjoyed learning and teaching others through experiments rather than from books. Today I am going to burn my money. Yes, you heard me right. I am literally going to burn my money to make you learn something. Let us begin by asking an important question. What is combustion? For combustion to take place, you require these four things in proper combination. Let us go through each one of them. First is activation energy. Have you ever noticed that you should bring the flame very close to a piece of paper for it to catch fire? Even if I do this all day, the paper won't catch fire. That is because I am not providing the energy required to start the reaction. This energy is called as activation energy. Only when I provide this energy will the reaction start, and only then will the paper burn. Next, let us look at the fuel and oxidant. So obviously the oxygen in the air is the oxidant. There is nothing interesting about it, but there is something very interesting about the fuel. Would you believe me if I say that actually the paper is not burning?
Sorry, what?
Yeah, that's the truth. Let me explain. So paper is made up of cellulose. When I heat it, the cellulose in the paper starts to undergo a chemical reaction with itself, and it turns into a tar and some gases. The gases are mostly hydrogen, carbon monoxide and other hydrocarbons. And these gases are flammable. So that's what actually starts on fire when you light a paper on fire. This is due to pyrolysis. If you look really closely, you'll notice that the flame is not actually attached to the paper at all, but it's burning above it, because what is actually burning is the gases above it. If you remember well, the fourth thing in the list was the energy to sustain combustion. Here I have a wet piece of paper. I can provide the activation energy and start the reaction, but if I remove the flame, the heat is absorbed by the water and the gases don't get enough heat to burn. This is also the reason why a balloon filled with water doesn't pop when you bring a flame near it. Now it's time to make the fuel, which is a 1:1 mixture of isopropyl alcohol and water. So let's burn some money. First up, American dollars. It's important that the entire banknote is completely soaked in the solution, or else you will be really left with ashes. So be careful. Next, the Indian rupees. So I haven't still explained why the banknotes don't turn into ashes. Maybe it's obvious by now, but still let me explain. When I light the banknotes on fire, the isopropyl alcohol starts burning. But the heat is absorbed by the water, which has a very high specific heat capacity. So the banknotes never get enough heat to start burning. Next, the euro, and I will be showing you some slow motion in few seconds. Once you have finished, don't forget to store the solution in a labeled container. So that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed learning through experiments. I will see you in the next video.